Let's finish up this series of webcasts by working through an FMO analysis for the hypothetical reaction between allyl cation and allyl anion. These are two species that we previously encountered when we talked about LCAO construction of three-atom pi systems. I've reproduced the pi energy levels shown here and LCAO representations of their molecular orbitals. To get the FMO analysis started, what we need to do is to consider the two possible frontier orbital interactions. We could, for example, consider homocation, lumoanion, or we could consider the homoanion, lumocation interaction. The second one looks much better because the much smaller energy gap between the homo of the anion and the lumo of the cation, and that makes perfect sense because we expect the negative charge on the anion to give a very high-level homo, and we expect the positive charge on the cation to give a low-lying lumo. So let's focus on that as the major frontier orbital interaction, and the next thing we need to do is identify the way in which they'll come together in order to form a reaction. So we focus on these two LCAO representations of their molecular orbitals, and we try to match coefficients both in terms of sign and in terms of the size of the coefficients. Well, in this case, because the molecules are symmetrical, the two coefficients happen to be identical in size, and so we don't need to worry about size. All we need to do is to make sure that the lobes come together with the same sign so that when we multiply those two coefficients, we get a positive term in that equation that describes the energy of interaction. That's the way they should come together. What it says is the two terminal carbons should come together. And if we look at the bonds and atoms that are drawn on at the bottom, we could imagine that the curved arrows would indeed reproduce that same picture. So that would be the curved arrow between the non-bonding lone pair and the empty orbital on the cation, and that would produce a new bonding interaction that would form the sigma bond between those two. Now, what about the alternative homo-lumo interaction? What if that had been considered? What would have been the result? Well, first of all, it's not considered because it's such a large energy difference between those two. But had it been considered, we would have gone through the same process of trying to match phases, largest lobes being the most important. And on this case, you can see that for the homocation, the largest lobe is in the center. And so if we match phase to the largest lobe on the anion, we would end up trying to bring those two species together. And then when we attempted to draw it out, well, it's a little bit strange, but we would expect a new bond to be formed there. And in order to do so, we end up with this very funny charged system that looks like that. Maybe we would try and combine positive and negative charges to make the structure that's shown here. This is a simple hypothetical example. We didn't have to go through the FMO analysis to predict that this isn't the observed pathway, but the observed pathway is just what you would expect. Nonetheless, I think from this example you can see how the FMO analysis is going to work for cases that, not like this one, but where we wouldn't be able to predict which reaction pathway would be more favorable. And we'll see plenty of examples throughout the semester of this sort of analysis.